Today on the channel, we're going to be taking a look at this PTZOptics Move 4K 30x Zoom camera. Now, this thing is almost as large as its name is, but first and foremost, thank you to PTZOptics for sending this over for review. It boasts a wide variety of impressive specifications and features that are meant to elevate your video production capabilities, so I'm very anxious to check it out. So let's go ahead and take a look, shall we? And as the name suggests in the 4K branding on the front of this is 4K resolution compatible, all the way up to 60 frames per second. You can even do 1080p, 60 frames per second over SDI. So it really kind of helps you future-proof your video production capabilities, because you're not gonna buy this and immediately 6 months down the line is something gonna come out where it's already outdated and no longer capable. 4K resolution at 60 frames per second is pretty much as good as it gets right now in video production, at least in the YouTube space. Now, this particular model is the 30x optical zoom. They do have smaller zoom ranges, so you got 12x as well as 20x should you not need that full zoom distance of 30x. But this thing is quite impressive because it can actually lock onto a person from 300 feet away and track their movements. Yes, that's right, you heard me. Auto tracking is built into this device. Very impressive, all the way fully zoomed in. It can zoom in to 300 feet, lock onto the subject and track them across the distance. And even if you're doing something like a stage play or a presentation with multiple people on the stage, you can choose the individual you wish it to track as they move left to right, up and down, what have you. It will still lock onto them regardless of how many other people are in the background, which is quite impressive. Now, there's a couple of different ways you can control that. You can control it with the standard remote, which came very simple to do, zoom in, zoom out. But we also have pan up, pan down, full rotation. I mean, this thing has all the axis covered. Very impressive. They also have different accessories you can buy should you need to mount this on a pole, mount it on the wall, security camera, you name it. Very versatile as far as installation and its, you know, applicable use case scenarios. But for presenters alike, this is definitely going to be something you're really going to wish you had in your arsenal, because like I said, just that auto tracking capabilities, no longer are you relegated to having a dedicated camera person following you left, right, up and down as you're moving across a scene. This can do that automatically. What it can't do though is zoom in on your hands. So say you're doing a top-down presentation and you're moving from one side to the screen to the other, it's not gonna track your hands. It needs to have that face in space. So keep that in mind. So a couple of nuances about the pan and tilt and just overall motion control of this device. You are able to slow and speed up the zoom capabilities. So you want to zoom in fast, zoom out slow, you can do that. However, if you want to pan and tilt at a different speed, now unfortunately that's not something you can do on the remote currently. So while you can't control the pan or the tilt speed using the remote control, you can do it inside the application. It's very easy. You go up and down, selecting your number and your speed. We'll go ahead and turn the pan speed down to a 6, pan around my messy room. And as you can see, it has slowed down considerably. We'll go ahead and speed it up all the way to 20. And it zips back across very quickly. Stunning visual clarity aside, this thing boasts an impressive array of inputs and outputs around back. That way it can be as absolutely versatile as possible. It'll fit within any kind of workspace you got. Let's go ahead and check out the ports. So we've got a line in, a line out for 3.5 millimeter audio. We've got our DC 12 volt in power source. This device is also NDI HX compatible. So if your setup allows for it, you can technically power and control this entire device using a single Ethernet cable, which is very, very handy. Now we also have our two RS232 in and out ports right there on the back. We have our 3G SDI, HDMI out, of course. You name it, this thing has got it. We got a USB 2.0 port, and we have a little dial in here that automatically allows you to lock down the configuration for resolution and frame rate. We've got a little handy key there at the bottom that shows the different frame rates and dial specifications for you. But like I said, you can control it in software, or you can physically dial that down and lock down whatever resolution you wish. And when it comes to different options on how to control this beautiful beast, you got as many as your heart's desire. First and foremost is the included remote that comes with the camera. Now this looks like a standard television remote, but not the case. So the numbers up there, those represent presets. So think of it like this way. You can set your scene in different camera options. So you can come over here, left-hand corner, zoom in, zoom out, frame your scene, set that as option one. Come over here, front and center, zoom out, option two. Over here, zoom in, option three. Set all those settings and you press 1, 2, and 3 and the camera will automatically fix to those spaces, and that way you have a controlled environment. So you have like a full functional television production studio at your fingertips with a remote. You can also turn on the auto tracking feature. You turn it off. You can zoom in, you can zoom out, you can pan up, you can pan down, left, right, you name it. It can all be controlled with the remote. Now, if you don't want to use the remote because it is an IR remote and you may be worried about distance of the actual signal, you can actually use the web application, which is very easy to do. You can control all those same features via the web interface. If you don't want to use the web interface, there's a dedicated application for your phone or your PC or your MacBook. Works on all of them. One thing to note though, I will say while using the iOS application, it works fine, but there is a little bit of jittering and stuttering as far as the live preview. I did not have that issue when I was using the web application or the dedicated application on my MacBook. You can also control this via OBS. So if you're an OBS user, you're streaming, you can control the camera within a plugin via OBS. So very impressive array of control options for you at your fingertips. Whatever suits your fancy, they've got something that allows you to control this camera.
So here's some of the pros and cons as I see it with this camera. So the 4K resolution combined with the high quality optics delivers an exceptional image quality. It captures every detail and clarity is very precise. It's got versatile zoom capabilities with that 30x optical zoom, which captures shots from various distances without sacrificing image quality, making it very suitable for wide angle and close up shots. The PTZ functionality offers flexibility in framing your shots, allowing you to pan, tilt, zoom, so you can easily capture dynamic footage. We have the easy integration with multiple connectivity options, so you have the app, you have their web interface, as well as the full on web application. You can use external controllers to control this. You can do live streaming directly from the camera. You don't even have to have your own broadcasting software, so it's very easy to use in that aspect. This camera was definitely constructed with durability in mind, built to withstand the rigors of professional use, and you can use it in a variety of different demanding environments, making sure you'll still have reliable performance, which is great. Now on the con side of thing, yes, it is expensive. And as with many high-end cameras, this PTZ Optics Move 4K 30X comes with a premium price tag. Now that may be a barrier for budget conscientious buyers, but it's one of those things where good things aren't cheap and cheap things aren't good. So keep that in mind when you're setting your budget. Complex setup for novices is definitely a little tricky when it comes to interfacing this and controlling it for first time people. It's not the most intuitive thing for people that have never used this type of camera before. So that is a little bit of a challenge for newcomers.
At the end of the day, this is a very impressive camera. Definitely a studio production quality level camera. 4K resolution looks nice, crystal clear, very sharp image. Zoomed in, you got a beautiful bokeh effect, which is really, really nice. 4K resolution, 60 frames per second. So that's kind of the top of the line for the industry right now. I do wish it went all the way up to 120 frames per second. Even if it was relegated down to 1080p at that, I still wish we got, 120 frames per second. That'd be really, really nice for the super fast moving objects and sports and things like that. But if you're doing something with production, you got a lot of people on screen, you need motion tracking, you need 4K resolution. Like I said, this thing's got built-in internal specifications that allow you to stream directly from the camera. You don't need any streaming software. This thing is as good as it gets. If you're interested in learning more or picking up one of these products, I'll put a link down in the video description box below. If you enjoyed the content, make sure you hit the like button, share this video with your friends if you found the information helpful, and as always, thanks for watching, guys. It really means a lot.